हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज नेक्रोसिस। नेक्रोसिस इज नथिंग बट दी इरिवर्सिबल सेल इंजुरी। इरिवर्सिबल सेल इंजुरी मे बी अ नेक्रोसिस और मे बी एन एपोप्टोसिस। एपोप्टोसिस वी विल सी लेटर, नाउ वी सी द नेक्रोसिस। नेक्रोसिस इज एन लोकलाइज एरिया ऑफ डेथ ऑफ टिश्यू फॉलोड बाय डीजनरेशन ऑफ टिश्यू by hydrolytic enzyme liberated from the dead cell. See what happened here, if any tissue or any cell because of lacking of blood supply may goes into a ischemia, cause a cell death. So this cell which having some changes or degradative changes by the liberation of hemolytic enzyme, that changes along with the some inflammatory reaction, it's called as a necrosis. That may be caused because of hypoxia. For example, if myocardium that supplies by a coronary artery get atherosclerosis causing a ischemia, and because of lacking of blood supply, oxygen supply to that particular tissue, tissue doesn't get the proper nutrition, so tissue doesn't want to complete his fulfillment, cannot goes into the liberation of energy for their energy production, for the synthesis of ATP. So this cell goes into a irreversible cell death. And while that, this myocardium, the cell of or tissue of that myocardium having some changes in that cell. This cellular changes, whatever is the happen, is the necrosis. So it may be caused because of hypoxia. It may be caused because of chemical injury, by a cyanide poisoning, by HCl poisoning, by a sulfuric acid poisoning, physical agents like mechanical injury, okay, or any microbial agent just like a fungus, histoplasmosis or mycobacterium tuberculosis, or any immunological injury just like autoimmune disease like arthritis can cause a necrosis. So whatever the causes of cell injury is the causes of necrosis. So types of necrosis. Necrosis are of five types. Coagulative necrosis, liquefactive necrosis is also called as colligative necrosis, gaseous necrosis, fat necrosis, fibrinoid necrosis. Coagulative necrosis is an irreversible cell injury caused by sudden cessation of blood flow, or maybe a bacterial or any chemical agent. But the most common involvement of organ is heart, kidney and spleen. In the early stage, coagulative necrosis is firm, slightly swollen, but with the progressive it has become yellowish, softer and sunken. Whatever, when this changes has happened, there are some changes in the nucleus. Whatever the chromatin is present in the nucleus of nucleus and cytoplasm, that become goes into degranulating process, dissolving process, okay, and condensation of this process. So this, while this changes happen in the coagulative necrosis, you can identify the structure of the cell. You can identify from where it is belong. The cell is belonging from which structure. But the internal membrane or internal interior of that cell, cytoplasm and nucleus, is lost. And that's why it is called as tombostone. Tombostone is nothing but the outer structure of cell is identified, recognized, but the internal cytoplasm and the nucleus detail get lost. Other type of necrosis is a liquefactive necrosis. Liquefactive necrosis is caused because of ischemic injury or bacteria or any fungal infection. Most common example is a brain infarct or abscess cavity where there is a liquefaction has been formed. Here the powerful hydrolytic enzyme which is liberating a watery consistency is more in action, is more powerful. Okay, so this hydrolytic enzyme causing effect, that is a liquefactive necrosis. Affected area is soft with the liquefied center. Cystic wall is formed just like a blister. Cystic space contains a necrotic cell, debris and macrophages filled up with the phagocytose material. Cell wall is formed by proliferation of capillaries, inflammatory cell and gliosis. Gliosis is a cells of brain. Okay, so or fibrinoblast in case of abscess cavity where there is a liquefactive necrosis is caused a central liquefactions or liquidification is formed there. This is a hallmark, and dead cell, macrophages and phagocytic materials are then surrounding with this. So cyst like structure is look like. Then caseous necrosis. Caseous necrosis is a combination of both coagulative necrosis and tubercular necrosis. If you saw the outer structure of cell is recognizable, but internally there is a liquefaction or liquefactive necrosis is seen. That's why it is called as combination of both coagulative necrosis and caseous necrosis. Caseous necrosis is formed in case of bacterial infection and fungal infection. In case of bacterial infection, most common example is Mycobacterium tuberculosis bacteria. In case of tuberculosis, the tuberculi, central tubercular foci is formed. When this tubercle bacteria is entered into a lung cavity, it forming a Ghon's complex. So this is while that forming this, so there is a formation of guma. This guma is nothing but the formation of giant cell. When this giant cell is formed, how this giant cell is formed, this bacteria come, and whenever any foreign particle is come inside the body, our body want to defense to their action. So our body defensor, just like a macrophages, eosinophils are come and want to engulf that bacteria. So in the center to kill that bacteria, so center dead cell, so centrally necrosis is present, but from the next to that the macrophages came and want to engulf that. Then epithelioidal cell are come, then again granular eosinophils are come, and then at the end to heal that injury the fibroblast are come, fibrosis is happened there. And with this some changes, one dead cell debris is formed. It's called as a foci, or you call it as a Langerhans of giant cell. This is a, this giant is formed. Giant is the nothing but the beaks, the beak dead cell. So this Langerhans ne usko giant bola. So that's why it's called as a Langerhans giant cell is formed there. But from the external it just look like as a dry cheese like appearance. So it is whitey in color and cheese like consistency, soft and granular and yellowish इट अपियर्स लाइक अ चीजी कंसिस्टेंसी. दिस नेक्रोस फोका इज स्ट्रक्चरलेस इओसिनोफिलिक एंड कंटेनिंग अ ग्रैनुलर डेब्रिस सराउंडेड बाय ग्रैनुलोमेटस इन्फ्लेमेटरी रिएक्शनरी कंसिस्टेंसी ऑफ एपिथेलॉइडल सेल विद द इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ जायंट सेल ऑफ लंगरहंस. व्हाट वी सी देन फैट नेक्रोसिस. सो फैट नेक्रोसिस इज अ स्पेशल फॉर्म ऑफ सेल डेथ. इट्स मे बी बिकॉज ऑफ acute pancreatitis followed by acute pancreatic necrosis or traumatic fat necrosis, most commonly in breast, where there is a more adipose tissue, there is a fat necrosis. In case of pancreas, there is a liberation of pancreatic lipase from injured or inflamed cell that result into a necrosis of pancreas as well as fat deposited throughout the peritoneal cavity. So extra abdominal adipose tissue may get also affect there. Fat necrosis is hydrolyze the neutralized fat which is present in adipose cell into a glycerol and free fatty acid. The damaged adipose cell resume a cloudy appearance and this free fatty acids form a complex with the calcium ion and forming a calcium soapy or sophistication soap like consistency is formed which is we see in the dystrophic calcification appears as a whitish yellow or yellowish white in color and firm deposition is there. Formation of this calcium soap impact the necrosed foci firm and chalky white like appearance is given. The cloudy appearance and surrounded by inflammatory reaction forming a calcium soap which is amorphous granular and basophilic material is present there. So last is a fibrinoid necrosis. Fibrinoid necrosis is characterized by deposition of fibrin like material which has a stain property of fibrin. It is seen in case of autoimmune disease mostly. Autoimmune disease like arthritis reaction also. So in case of hypertension, the arterioles get a fibrinoid necrosis. So small fibrinoid debris are come and causing the local hemorrhage and rupture of that blood vessel also. Here the neutrophils are come in action. Brightly eosinophil hyaline membrane deposition over the vessel wall is also seen. So but mostly the deposition of neutrophil, that is leukocytosis, is seen in the fibrinoid necrosis. Thank you. These are the details of necrosis. Thank you.